19. Read chapter 3 from the Quran. Read all the Quran if you can. What's going to happen? You're going to get more educated? Is that such a bad thing? Is it going to be better? Is it going to help our the humanity to understand each other? There's so many misconceptions, brothers and sisters, today. I'm sure there's people in this room who have misconceptions, who have come in here with some kind of feeling, some kind of, you know, hesitation. But we need to understand each other. If not, what's the point? So pick up a copy of the Quran and read more about Mary. Mary, the mother of Jesus. Now, let's move to that one person, that amazing, beautiful prophet, Jesus, peace be upon him. Let me say, peace be upon him. Alayhi salatu wasalam. As Muslims, we follow him, we love him, we praise him. But who was, what is the Quran teach? What does Islam say about Jesus? Well, the Quran says that Jesus was only a messenger, a prophet, a human being. A human being. Not only that, of course. Much better than us. But he was not God. All God says in the Quran, that we've sent Jesus as a messenger. And before him, we've sent many more messengers. Why is it such a big deal not to understand? Why is it a stumbling block, his virgin birth, when Adam had no mother, no father? When Eve had no mother or father, she was created from Adam. Imagine that. Adam created no mother, no father, or no male, no female. Eve, female, created no male. And Isa, Jesus, created from only a female, no father, no male. Because God can do anything that he wants. He just says, be it. For Jesus was a messenger. He was messengers before, and his mother was a righteous woman. When I read this verse, the next piece says, they ate what? They ate food. They ate food. And then God says, what? Look how we make the proofs evident. The proofs are clear. They ate food, the proofs are clear. The proofs are clear. What does this mean? So people say Jesus is God. Why would I need to eat food? Why would I need to eat food? Because food is sustenance for someone who is in need. Now people will say, well, fully God, fully man. But again, is the man overtaking the full man overtaking the full God for his hunger and the need of sustenance? We need to think. We need to think. The Quran tells us to think. I'm asking you today, another time, I'm asking you, please, just think. Because God is not just leaving that verse there, he's saying, look how we make the evidence clear. Very clear. When you eat, what do you do with all respect? You digest. You digest what you do with all respect. You go to the washroom. But the Quran says, God is high above all these things that they associate with. High above all these things. Perfection. I mean, I tell you this. Try to pick up a copy of the Quran to see who is God, the perfection of God. I'm sure you're getting this. So what is Jesus' message anyway? Okay, so it's a message. We're reading that. But what is his message? Well, actually, it's nothing new. Believe it or not. Because he came to preach in a long line of prophets, which were called the variables. And the constant was the same. The prophets changed, they're the variables. Different prophets came and went. Human beings, different parts. different people. But there was always one constant that never changed. What was that?
That there's only one God.
But Jesus says, worship Allah, my Lord, and your Lord. This is the right path. This is the right path. This is the right path. We look, brothers and sisters, evidently, of course there's people need to explain things to themselves. So there will be explanations, but does the explanations make sense? That's what I want you to think about it. Because Jesus is described as praying in the Bible. He's praying to who? God. Jesus is described as doing things. Based on what? Based on whose accord? Based on whose word? God's word. So again, going back to the sameness. One God. Say God is one. God is eternal, everlasting. The one that everyone needs to turn to. He begins not, nor is he begotten, and there's nothing like him. Son of God, God Mother, God Father, there's no such thing. And this is the Islam teaches. This was the message, the pure message of Jesus. There is only one God. He came to deliver that to the people. What about his miracles? Because people say Jesus was a miraculous name, you know, person. Don't those miracles prove something? And we say, of course they prove something. That God is great. That God can do these things. Because Jesus again said, I have nothing of my accord. It's only from God. The will of God. His will, not mine. Believe it, brothers and sisters, as Muslims, dear friends, we have to believe. The Quran said that Jesus brought things to life. Jesus cured lepers and this and that, many things. Jesus did those. Yes, Jesus. Those were his miracles. And other prophets had other miracles. And each prophet had miracles for themselves. But never did they claim that this is my miracle. This is I do it. No. They always say, this is from God. This is from God. What did the people at this time, what issue did they have with Jesus? He was giving them miracles. He was calling them to God. But you see, someone else asked me, why, if God exists and God has sent the message, why so many prophets? Why? The question is very simple. Because as human beings, we like to change things. So God kept sending prophets to remind us, to remind us. We like to go in extremes. We like to go in places that we're not supposed to go. And Jesus came to the children of Israel who took the law to such an extent that they were just being so harsh on everything and forgetting the spirit, the love, the mercy, the kindness that the law comes with, that the law protects. So they were in one extreme. So Jesus came to them and taught them, what does it mean to be merciful? What does it mean to be humble? What does it mean to be loving and kind within the spectrum of the law? People who came after him went to another extreme and they said, there is no law. It's only the love, it's only the mercy, it's only the covenant, it's only, you know, the covenant is not there. We say those are both too extreme, and Islam has brought the middle path, the right path, which teaches that the law preserves the love, and the love preserves the law.
This is my son, Jesus. This is what Jesus thought. This is Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.
Now, I know that some people might have some objections, but again, I ask you to be patient with me, to understand what we believe. And this is the issue of what happened to Jesus after we didn't like it. Some say that he was crucified. Right? Islam teaches something very amazing. That he was not crucified. People planned to crucify him. People planned to kill him. But God saved him, lifted him up to himself. And people thought that they're killing him. People thought and appeared to them that, yes, we're killing him. He's done. But God says, they thought that they did that. It appeared to them that they did this. But surely they did. And those who argue about this, those who say this, they're from nothing but conjecture. When we look today, we want to go to the objective study of what happened historically, as well as scripturally, we'll find what? Conjecture. God tells us, he did it. He saved his righteous servant. He saved him. He saved him as a sign. What does God say? That he will make those who follow him superior to those who don't. Till the day of judgment. Imagine that. Those who follow Jesus, now people are saying, I follow Jesus. But I want you to really think about this way. Those who follow Jesus till the day of judgment. Who follows Jesus? That's just, again, with all respect. Who follows Jesus? Jesus is described to make sujood, put his head on the floor while praying. Muslims do that. Most Christians don't. There's some small minority sects that do that. Muslims circumcise. Jesus circumcises. Our friends don't. Muslims don't eat pork. Jesus ate pork. The answer is obvious on the other side. Jesus washed before praying. And so we wash before praying. Jesus worshiped one God. And so we worship one God. So, you be the judge. Who are those that God describes as the followers of Jesus? You be the judge. Now, where did Jesus go? We said that Jesus was taken up, saved by God. Where do you go? Well, God tells us in the Quran that he will come back. God tells us through his prophet in the Hadith that he will come back. He will come back this earth. We as Muslims believe that. What's called the second coming. We believe in that. He will come and he will bring peace to this earth. And he will come. But he will come. Excuse me. As a Muslim. Because he's always a Muslim. A Muslim means the one who submits to God. Submits his will to God. And Jesus was that. What do you say right now? He prayed this way? He cleaned himself this way? He had the same diet? It's evident. So Jesus will come back. Testifying that there's only one God. Testifying to what we testify. To what we invite people to testify.
that there's only